you wanna, live how you wanna, spend what you wanna, be who you wanna be. A young stunner till I die.
Be ready. Are you filming?
Yeah, I'm filming it.
Finally. I forgot my hat. Gotta go get my hat, but it's range day, baby. Going to the range. It's me and Jay. And we're meeting Kurt. Got some guns to review today. It's gonna be pretty dope. And I'm excited about one of them that we're gonna film. I'm excited about all of them, but one of them is very near and dear to my heart. So it's the Shield Plus, the 4-inch performance center. Not yet. I'm still in my slippers. So let me go get the right hat, and I'm gonna wear my slippers anyway. It's all about comfort.
We're looking for lotion because we ashy.
Hey, the OGs know. They know I'm always ashy. So Kurt put us onto this hand sanitizer that is nourishing. It has shea butter and warmth. And it's dope because your hands ain't ashy. And you know all the hand sanitizer that's out now, it all smells like tequila. Anybody trying to get drunk and shoot guns? Damn. But anyway, this stuff is dope. Like, so if you have noticed that maybe the last video or two I wasn't as ashy, it was because of Kurt. And the hand sanitizer, look at it. Look, my hands feel luxurious, but they ain't greasy. I hate greasy. I hate lotion. That's why I'm always ashy. But look, you're gonna find out why the 4-inch Performance Center Ported Shield Plus is my favorite micro compact. And you're gonna find out why I think it is the micro compact of 2021 and 2022. I feel like I didn't even like intro the vid yet.
Nah. Well, I mean, it was good. It was not a, hey, it's Ken with Provectus.
Hi, I'm Ken with Smith & Wesson. What it do? It's your boy Ken with Provectus Group. It's morning. Yeah. It's morning time. I'm always in a great mood for the most part, but it's still morning. But I hope everybody's doing good. Hope the Provectus family's doing good. Provectus alumni. Provectus Army.
Yes, sir.
It's dope. Last night, Provectus Army got the video that's going live today at 8 o'clock. Provectus Army got that last night, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I saw some of the comments. Love the video. I really like that video, too. That video we were talking about, the trigger in the new Smith & Wesson M2.0s. The flat trigger. Oh, it's dope. It is dope. And I haven't even, like, done a detailed in-depth vid, but that vid is, man, it's good. If you want to know what I think about that trigger, go and check it out. We're trying to do something different. We want these to be entertaining and educational, you know, but we're gonna have a lot of damn fun. That's the biggest part. But yeah, hope y'all enjoying it. Today's gonna be a dope ass day. Doesn't get no better than this. We're in one of the new F-150s.
I didn't even know this is a new one.
Yeah, this is a different one, man. What do you think about the screen there? This is courtesy of Pugmire Ford, Cartersville, Georgia. We have a surprise on the way, but we're driving this.
Surprise taking a bit too long.
It is, but the surprise is here in Atlanta. I found out yesterday, so that's dope. All right, enough of that crap. Let's head to the range. Are we hot?
We hot. We rolling.
Cool. All right. So we're talking about what I think is the best micro compact 2022 as of right now. This is February 2022. Full disclaimer, before the Shield Pluses came out, I was carrying a SIG P365XL, and this is what I had on it. I mean, I had a Hollister 507K. You still see my witness marks from back in the day. She still has battery. Put a Streamlight TLR6 on it. And an Ameriglow front sight. So this is what I was carrying. And Smith & Wesson knew that, you know. And anyway, so just that, there's that disclaimer, you know, because obviously, you know, I'm a brand ambassador for Smith & Wesson, but what I'm gonna talk to you about today is just reality, okay?
So yes, I was carrying a SIG. Actually had some input in the new Shield Plus, which was absolutely amazing. Thank you so much, Smith & Wesson. We talked about it. Hey, you know, and this is awesome when you're talking about a company that's listening to people. You know, my ears to the ground. You know, we're teaching a lot of people every year, and we're listening to their concerns every time. And we talked to them, hey, we need more capacity, you know, and let's consider a flat trigger. And I offered some reasons why a flat trigger is a better idea. And here we go. And I'm not going to say that I'm the reason for it, but all I will say is that I was allowed to have some input. So thank you again, Smith & Wesson. Anyway, here comes the Shield Plus. Okay, so the one that came out was this one. This was the first one that they sent me. So this one was not optic ready, flat face trigger. And so I was comparing it in my mind, and you know, physically I was comparing it to the old original Shield. I was comparing it to this one. This is the original Shield. The one that holds 7 rounds, you know, 8 with 1 in the chamber. And so I was comparing it to that one. Biggest thing, like we said earlier, is how snappy is it gonna be? You know, when you bring the size down of the firearm, you reduce the weight, it's gonna increase the perceived recoil. And what I mean by perceived recoil is, you know, when you're talking about a 9mm round, you know, this one here, you know, this round is gonna produce a certain amount of energy, right? So that's the actual force that's being created. But the weight of the gun, and its mass will absorb some of that energy. What energy that's left over, that was not absorbed, is what you perceive. That's what we feel, so that perceived recoil. So when we go from like something like this size, which is a full-size firearm, it's a 5-inch MP performance center. This thing weighs a little bit, 9mm. And then we come all the way down to something like this, it's still 9mm. Still the same amount of initial force that's being generated inside of this chamber, right? So like we were saying earlier, usually the smaller the firearm, the more that perceived recoil you're gonna feel. So a lot of people, including myself, would say, hey, when you're talking about micro compact pistols in general, they're snappy. And what we mean by that is when you're firing the firearm, it feels like it wants to come out of your hand. Doesn't mean that it will, it just feels that way. So I wanted to initially compare it to the original Shield. One of the biggest things in my mind that I was considering is the additional weight. So they went, and correct me, I could be wrong, but if I remember correctly, the width of the old Shield was something like 0.95 inches in width. And they went to 1.1 inches or something like that with the new Shield Plus. I will say that it, when it's in your hand, you can feel a difference. It's wider in the areas that it needs to be wider in. And actually, I have more of the palm of my hand actually coming in contact with the firearm, which is great. But you can tell that it's wider when it's in your hand. But when you're carrying it and it's on your hip or appendix, you can't. You still get that, you know, awesome concealability. You still get that firearm that it feels like it disappears. And what I mean is you'll go 2, 3, 4 hours and forget that you even have a firearm on. And that's what makes, you know, carrying a firearm, especially every single day, a lot more enjoyable. And that's the reason why micro compacts are so popular. So I shot it. Immediately could tell a difference. I felt like I had more control of the firearm. I attribute that to the wider grip and the change in the grip texture. Flat trigger, holy cow. It was nice, period. It's a flat trigger, but it was very clean. And what I mean by that is I'm gonna do this left-handed, when you place your finger on a trigger and you pull back rearward, you're gonna pull back until you feel some resistance. That resistance is what we call the wall. From here to there, very clean, nice and smooth. It actually feels like the internals are polished, or it feels like an action or a trigger pull after you polished your trigger. It already feels like that from the factory. So the wall definitely defined. You know that you're on the wall. There's no doubting it. I love that because when you talk about using this firearm to defend yourself in a situation where it's super, super high stress, you're panicked, you're freaking out, you know, there's a lot of things going on. I want to know for a fact I'm on the wall, especially in a situation like that. Now, let's look at this. I'm on the wall here. Now I'm going to gradually increase the pressure. Very, very nice clean break. Usually we refer to this as over travel, and that's everything past the break. You heard that click. That's what I'm referring to as the break. It's very, very clean. You see it's not very much travel. Now I'm gonna pin this trigger to the rear. I wanna feel that reset. Right there, that's it. Let's do that one more time. That's it, you're there. So the trigger was very, very nice. Very nice trigger. Excellent for, and it was a good balance trigger as well, because it was enough poundage for self-defense, but also light enough to where you can get the long distance shots in there, you know, your 25 yard, 50, 100 yard shots. So I really liked it. So then comes the 4-inch performance center. Okay, now they came out with two different versions. We had a 4-inch that was non-ported like this one, and it was optic ready. Comes with the Crimson Trace optic, comes with the fiber optic sights, came with the exact same flat trigger like we were talking about before, same new width, same new grip texture, and it feels great. Now you see how it looks here. Let me show you how this looks. All right, so this magazine helps a ton. It's a 13 round magazine, but it adds more to your grip. So they came out with the 4-inch. Both of these are the 4-inch. This one is ported. This one isn't. Exact same pistols. Now, let's compare this, because when you're talking about a 4-inch, and I'm gonna go ahead and put the magazine in there that I normally use, let's compare it to a 4-inch pistol. Here's a bone stock one. Here's one of the absolute brand new ones. This is a 4-inch optic ready. This is the new flat trigger, 15 round. This thing is unloaded. But let's look at this. Let's show the people. Overall, when you look at the side profile, I don't know if you can get straight down on top of that. All right, awesome. So you see that. But overall, this is the same. But let me show you. This is why this pistol is so awesome. Look at the difference in the width. Okay, now that's a 4-inch M&P. Here's a Glock. It's a Glock 17, but what we're doing is we're comparing the width. Look at that. There is a substantial difference. Now, when we're talking about capacity, this right here, 15 rounds, plus one in the chamber. So you got 16. This one here is 14 overall, 13 plus one. And I will sacrifice the 2 rounds for this comfort, okay? Now, on top of that, being that it's ported, being that this one is ported, the recoil is softer. The perceived recoil that I feel is less than on the 4-inch M&P double stack. Now, obviously that's my opinion, but that's what I've felt and experienced, and every other person that I've put that firearm, you know, I let them try it out. They say the exact same thing. They're just like, oh my gosh, it's enjoyable. It's slim. It disappears. It's extremely comfortable. It holds has the capacity now, but heck, it shoots just as good, if not better, than the larger counterpart. So I just wanted to, you know, share this with you guys. I hope you enjoy this info, because this is really why I carry this. When I'm carrying a micro compact, this is it. So yeah, stay tuned.
My signature fade with a bevel blade, that's a major key. I told her she's smart and loyal, I like that, that's a major key. Start a label, run it, sign yourself, that's a major key.